RTMC is the real-time monitoring and control software from Campbell Scientific. RTMC is included in LoggerNet, LoggerNet Admin, and RTDAC software. It graphically displays data, changes variables or input locations, and toggles ports and flags. RTMC can also combine data from multiple data loggers on a single display. As LoggerNet collects data from the data loggers, the displays in RTMC are automatically updated. RTMC Pro is also available from Campbell Scientific. This enhanced version of RTMC includes an expanded library of components for creating custom displays. RTMC Pro can also display data from additional sources, such as stored data tables. I'll demonstrate RTMC Pro in another video. For now, I will demonstrate the standard RTMC. RTMC displays data from the LoggerNet binary data cache, not from a collected data file. Data must be collected from the data logger for the data cache to be updated, and therefore for the RTMC displays to be updated. Typically, this is done by setting up a schedule in the LoggerNet setup window. From the LoggerNet toolbar, select the main category, then Setup. Select the data logger to display the data from. Select the Schedule tab. Check the Scheduled Collection Enabled box. Next, determine a collection interval. There are several things to consider. How often are the measurements being taken and data stored? How often does the data display need to be updated? What is the communications method? When an expensive communications link, like a cellular modem, is used, collecting data and updating RTMC screens will likely occur less frequently than when a direct connection to the data logger is used. For this tutorial, I'm using a direct connection and want to have the screens display real-time values. The program takes measurements every second, so I'll also set the scheduled collection interval to 1 second. Go to the Data Files tab. By default, the stored data tables are included for scheduled collection. They have a green check in front, and the Included for Scheduled Collection box is checked. The public table, however, needs to be included so I can display real-time or near real-time values. Make sure to apply any changes made to the network setup. Here's a helpful hint. If the message "network is locked" appears when you try to send a program, it usually means that there are changes in the setup screen that need to be either applied or canceled. I'm done with the setup screen and setting up scheduled collection. Next, I'll open RTMC Development in LoggerNet. I've also installed RTMC Pro on this computer, so it appears here as well. But in this tutorial, I'll use the standard version. Watch for another video covering the features of RTMC Pro. In this project, I'll place several different components on the screen. A thermometer, text, numeric data values, a chart of data, and an alarm. I'll end up with something like this. The graphical component will be a thermometer. Click in the workspace to place the component. RTMC is a click and click program, not drag and drop. The properties box for that component is displayed. First, I'll select the data source for this component to display. All the data loggers in the network are available. I'll choose the CR1000X where I just set up scheduled collection. Here I can see which tables are being collected on a schedule. They have the green check. This is what I configured in the setup screen. Since the thermometer will display real-time values, I'll select the air temperature measurement from the public table. There are several component properties that I can change to get the look I'm after. Notice that as I make changes, they are reflected on the component in the workspace. Components can be resized by dragging a handle. Once a component is added, I can double-click it to bring up its properties box again for further editing. Right-clicking also lets me open the component's properties. Next, it's time to add a label. Place it in the workspace and enter a name for the measurement. I'll label this temperature. Now I'll add a digital display to show the numeric value of the air temperature that is displayed on the thermometer. Remember, this is coming from the public table. Here's a little hint. Press and hold the Alt key while entering 0176 on the numeric keyboard to get the degrees symbol. There are tools to help me get components organized on the screen. Once several components are selected, the alignment, spacing, sizing, centering, and ordering tools become available. The ordering tools are particularly useful in layering images and transparent components. I'll align the thermometer, label, and data value. Notice on the left, the project tree shows which components are selected. When editing, I can select components from this list or the workspace. Now I want to show some additional features. Alarms provide visual and/or audible notification that a data value has exceeded a defined limit. In this case, I have a variable that calculates the difference in temperature between the air and data logger. It's called delta T. When the difference in temperature is greater than 3, I have an alarm condition. I can use any image I already have. Many graphic file types are supported. RTMC includes images as well. Select one to be displayed when the condition is met, and another for when it is not. There are a lot to choose from, or I could just use my own. Next, I'll add a chart to display historic data. The previous components, thermometer and digital display, display data from a single point in time. The public and status tables work well as data sources for this type of component. But if I want to show some history of my data, I'll want to pull that data from a stored data table. The chart itself has properties. The Series tab is where I select the data source to be displayed. This time I'm displaying data from a stored data table, not the public table. Here I pick the max, mins, averages, etc. Click the Add button to add additional traces the same way. Now it's time to test the project. Click the Save and Run icon on the top row of icons. To test this project, I will warm the thermocouple on the data logger so delta T is greater than 3. If the alarm turns red when delta T is greater than 3 and turns back off when delta T is 3 or less than 3, then the project is working correctly. Closing the runtime screen takes me back to development mode. Now I'll show how to use an expression. I want to display the air temperature in degrees Fahrenheit this time, so I'll add another digital display below the first. Put the cursor in the data selection field and enter the expression, asterisk 1.8 plus 32, to change the degrees from centigrade to Fahrenheit. Use Alt 0176 for the degrees symbol. I now see both Celsius and Fahrenheit degrees being displayed. Expressions can include simple math, functions to manipulate strings, or more complex functions that deal with the state of a data value over time. The RTMC Help has an extensive section on using expressions. Here's another RTMC project that shows some features I haven't demonstrated. This project displays data from two stations on different tabs. Because the data is similar, I simply duplicated the screen and made minor edits from there. I'm also using a gauge and compass for wind data and an image behind some components. The time of last data collection provides valuable information as well. The screens I showed at the beginning of this tutorial make good use of background images and color. Look for the background image selection tool in the RTMC screen menu. Here's a troubleshooting tip. If an exclamation point appears at the upper right of a component, there is a problem with the linked data value. The main cause of this is that scheduled data collection is not running. In this case, I can see in the lower right that the LoggerNet server is disconnected. In development mode, hovering the mouse pointer over the box for a few seconds will display a pop-up hint about the error RTMC has detected. Watch for another video tutorial covering the additional features of RTMC Pro. Please contact Campbell Scientific to discuss your application, and for answers about RTMC, real-time monitoring and control,